Welcome guys, I am Parinita. Subscribe my channel and press the bell icon to receive regular notifications regarding the computer science topics and technical job updates. Hello guys, I am Parinita and welcome to my channel to polish your CSE concepts with me. So, let's get started. In today's video, we are going to see erosion and dilation in image processing. Actually, I have already uploaded one video of image processing, that is how to find out mPath, 8-path and 4-path. Then I have been getting multiple requests from you people that you want more videos regarding the operations in image processing. So yes, here we are. So from now onwards, I am continuing that series and I will be uploading various techniques of image processing. Fine. So today we are here with two morphological operation, important morphological operation of the image processing, that is erosion and dilation. Fine. So what do we mean by erosion and dilation? In simple words, you can say that erosion means, like as the name itself indicates, we are seeing the operations on image processing means what? You will be having image. You must know that image is actually what? Images are normally nothing but they are digitally. If normally what is image, we all know, right? But if we want to display or represent any image digitally, how we are doing it? We are doing it in the form of matrix and in binary digits like 0 and 1. So you can say that this is a form of image, this is a form of image, right? So in simple words, if I tell you about erosion and dilation, then any image is given to you. Erosion is basically shrinking that image, and against it, dilation is actually expanding an image. Fine. So in simple words, you can say that erosion is shrinking the image and dilation is expanding an image. Now, normally which type of questions are being asked? You will be given two segments, segment A and segment B, like any two segments in which one segment will be your image segment and the other segment will be your structuring element. For example, this is a question given, and in this question, they have told you that segment A is the image segment and segment B is the structuring element segment, right? Now we have to perform erosion and dilation. Let me write it here. This is, consider it as the image segment and consider it as the structuring element segment. And they are asking us, structuring element, and they are asking us to perform erosion and dilation on this specific image. Now how to do it? Actually, if you see in books, then in erosion and dilation we will be having different formulas. We can apply the formula and we can find it out, but it is quite complicated, or students are normally finding it quite difficult to do that, or quite confusing. So in this video I will be showing you a shortcut. Sorry. So in this video I will be showing you a shortcut on the basis of which you will be able to find out the erosion and dilation very quickly without any formula. You can directly see the question and you can give the answer. So we will see that trick here. For example, first of all, we want to find out erosion, right? Erosion. Now erosion, or A eroded B, can be written as A erosion B. This is the symbol of erosion, right? A erosion B is written like that. Now if I want to find out A erosion B, how to find it out? This is the segment, or this is the structuring element. How to find out erosion? See here, it is very simple. You have to consider it like you are, one will be, as I told, one will be the image segment, one will be the structuring element. What you need to do is, we will consider it like that. This is the center element of the structuring element, right? So consider it like that. You are holding the center of the structuring element, this one, because this is the center. So you are holding the center of the segment element of the structuring element, and you are trying to put that center one by one in all the places of the image segment, and wherever all the ones are covered with the ones. Note it down that in case of erosion, whenever all the ones are covered by all ones, we can put it one in this place. How to do it? See, if I am holding this one, what I want as per the structuring element, what I want that particular position should be 1, as well as its right and left hand side should also be 1, and its top and bottom should also be 1. Now if I put 1 here, will it be satisfied? No, because the center element itself is not 1. So remove all these things. So all these zeros will be 0 as it is. Now this 0, obviously the place where I am already having 0, if I put the center element there, then obviously this center element itself is not matching, because the center element is 1 and here we are having 0. So it will not match. So all the zeros will be as it is. No need to worry about that. You just have to consider the ones, right? Now what I will do is, I will just try to put the center one by one in place of all these ones, and I will try to see if I am getting all these 5 ones as it is, right? So yes, all the zeros are as it is, we have written them. Now I will try to put the center one here. If I try to put the center one here, this 1 and 1 is matched. Right hand side is 1, this is also matched, but left hand side is not 1. Here left hand side also we want 1. What we want the center as 1, left and right as 1, and top and bottom as 1. Here 1 is there at center, right is 1, but left is not 1. So this element will not come. Here if I try to put the center element here, then left and right are satisfied, bottom is satisfied, but top is not satisfied. So again, this will not come. Here left and bottom is satisfied, but right and top is not satisfied. So again 0. Similarly, if you put here also, in this here, if I take it as middle element, then again left is not satisfied. If I take here, bottom is not satisfied, bottom is not satisfied, bottom is not satisfied. In this case also, right is not satisfied. In this case also, right is not satisfied. So all these edges will be 0. If I consider this one, if I try to put this middle one as here, then this middle element one is satisfied, right one is satisfied, left one is satisfied, top one is satisfied, bottom one is also satisfied. Like this, all the 5 ones are satisfied. So I can say that yes, this will come as 1 in my answer. So this is whole your erosion. After erosion, we will get the matrix like this. So this is the answer of your erosion. Simple as that. Right? Now what we will consider? Now we are having dilation. Dilation is just the opposite of erosion. Dilation is specified with the help of this symbol. This is the symbol of dilation, right? Now how to do dilation? It will be completely opposite to that. In case of erosion, what we were seeing, that concept will be same, that we will try to place the center element of the structuring element one by one in the image elements. But in case of erosion, the only difference is, in case of erosion, we were seeing that all the ones should be covered. But in case of dilation, we will make sure that at least any out of these 5 ones, at least any one should be satisfied. If any one is satisfied, I can write that element as 1 in my answer. Like if I write it here, then center is not 1, neither left or right is 1, neither top or bottom is 1. So here nothing is satisfied, so I have to put it as 0. But here here if I put as 1, center is not satisfied, left and right are not satisfied, top is not satisfied, but bottom one is satisfied. And as I told in dilation, if any one is satisfied, I can consider it in my answer. So here, yes, bottom one is satisfied, so I will put it as 1. Here also bottom one is satisfied, so 1. Here also bottom one, 1. But again here, top, down, left, right, nothing is satisfied, so this will remain 0 as it is. In this case, bottom, top, and left are not satisfied, but right one is 1. Right, in the right place I am having 1. So out of all these, only this is satisfied. So here at least 1 is satisfied, so I will put 1 here. Similarly, here also right is satisfied, right is satisfied. So these two will also be 1. Now if I consider this, top, bottom, left, right, nothing is satisfied. In all the places we are having 0, no ones are there. So it will remain as 0 as it is. Similarly here, See, wherever we are having one, they will obviously come as it is because center is one. So the elements which are one itself, that means at least the center is satisfied. So obviously in at least one, all these ones will come. So all these ones will be as it is. And here top is satisfied, top is satisfied, top is satisfied. So all these three will come in our answer. Here also in case of these three, our left side is satisfied. So all these three will also be one. But if I consider here, top is not satisfied, bottom is not satisfied, left and right are not satisfied. So here we will get 0. So this is how dilation answer will be. So this is the answer of erosion. As you can see, in erosion, always the number of ones will decrease from the original image. And in case of dilation, the number of ones will increase from the original image. So this is the answer after erosion and this is the answer after dilation. Fine. I hope you have understood the whole concept of erosion and dilation, how to find it out. These are the two answers. In case you are new to my channel, please subscribe the channel. And if you liked my video, if you got the whole concept, please like, comment and share with your friends. That's all I want from you. Take care.